Welcome to VSDC channel. If you are hunting for video intro ideas, this is the tutorial you need. We'll show you how to recreate this intro, and if you like what you see, you can download the template from the description below. Without further ado, let's see how it's done. Launch VSDC and create a new project. If the image doesn't fit the size of the scene, just use the autocrop feature. Add a background image and set its duration at 3 seconds. Create a rectangle. Stretch it to the size of the scene and go to the Properties window. Select Gradient Background. Also, switch to the hard light blending mode. Make a click on the background image and apply the zoom effect. Find levels and set linear parameter change along the trajectory. Take a look at the graph. There are 5 control points on the timeline where we'll be changing the values. Check them out. 0 point. One second. Two seconds. Two and a half seconds. Three seconds. Add another rectangle with a solid background. Apply a movement feature to the second rectangle. Then set the movement vector between the second and the third control points. In the Properties window, set the following parameters. Path start point, yes. Start speed, 0. Okay, let's go back to the main timeline tab and add a headline. Convert the headline into a sprite. Then make a click on the text and place it right above the contoured sprite zone. Apply movement to the text too. In the Properties window, set the following parameters. Path start point, yes. Start speed, 0. Notice, the movement path here consists of 2 steps. From 0 point to the first second, and from there to the third control point, which is 2 seconds on the timeline. Back to the main timeline tab. Select the sprite and open its properties. Check the following parameters. Use as container? No. Show effects? Yes. Fill background? No. Duplicate the sprite and drag the copy 1 second further on the timeline. Make a double click on it and edit the text. Then make a double click on the text and remove the second part of the movement vector. Create a subhead . Convert it into a sprite, then open the sprite and move the text part below the contoured sprite zone. Again, apply movement to the text. In the properties window, set the following parameters. Path start point, yes. Start speed, 0. Set the movement vector between 2 seconds and 2 seconds and a half. Go back to the main timeline tab again and open the sprite properties. Use as container? No. Show effects? Yes. Fill background? No. Give us the thumbs up if you liked this tutorial and leave a comment below if there is anything you'd like us to cover on the channel. Until next time!